I like acting. I like it's weird. It's a small room. I like
you just
acting.
Loud enough, you don't need it.
No, I know, and I'm a loud speaker. You know, I like acting, and I like blood, and I like killing people. My mom was an agent, so I was always around Hollywood, and I knew that if I wasn't playing baseball, I would act. So I was playing college baseball, and I literally realized I wasn't having fun anymore. So I walked off the baseball field, didn't say bye to my teammates, and quit school, and said, "Mom, I'm gonna start acting now." So it was like that day. I just lost the fun. I mean, baseball, it's a game, and when it doesn't become a game, then you have to quit.
Okay. You didn't train?
For acting?
Yeah.
Mm. No, this is all natural. I wake up looking like this. when I was a kid, I had a really bad stutter. I couldn't talk.
Okay.
So I took an acting class just to kind of get over that. And then I started just kind of doing commercials and stuff. Then Buffy was the first thing first acting gig I had. I miss Andrew. I miss that character. It'll never happen. For it's just the people that own the show, because Joss doesn't own it. They just want too much money to redo anything. So tragically, like nothing Buffy related will ever happen again. But yeah, no, I would do it for free. I actually have this reoccurring dream, and I'm not joking. I've had at least 10 times that they're gonna shoot season 8, but they didn't ask me. Because all the characters, and then one of them, I actually sneak on set, and they have security remove me. Yeah, that's my own problems. I think I should probably talk to my therapist about that. Yeah. No, I mean, well, it was an interesting shoot because there wasn't a script; it was all improv.
Oh, really?
And so all the actors had notes that they had to convey. It was all shot in chronological order. So as things were happening, we didn't know what was happening. So we're reacting to the things that are happening. But also too, it gets so confusing that it's just, I have no idea what like time continuum I'm in. And it doesn't particularly matter, you know?
Yeah.
But I think more like the process of shooting it was, I didn't know how the movie ended because there wasn't a script and I wasn't in the last scene. So the first time I saw the movie, I was like, shit. I mean, I went all over the world for that movie. So many festivals.
Yeah.
It was great. Awesome. I do. I love the idea because I wasn't hired to be a singer or a dancer, so if I sucked, it didn't matter. I would love to finally meet my dad. He won't take my phone calls. Oh, an actor?
Yeah.
Oh, my bad.
No.
I don't know. I would love to have met. Like, I gotta go old school. Like Cary Grant. That's someone that. There's nobody, fuck no, man. I mean, Tom Hardy.
Really?
I love Tom Hardy. I'll actually see a movie because he's in it, except for Mad Max, because that's just not my thing. I had a dream once about Matthew McConaughey.
Oh.
Like, he was picking me up, like, it's at an airport, McConaughey's there, but
but he's there to kill me. So then I'm running, and then it's like, but it's weird. It's like it's LA and then it's Spain. I'm all over the map. And then he kills me, and then I wake up and I'm at the airport again, and there's Makani. And basically, I'm learning his moves from him killing me all the time to where I finally just kill him. Why I didn't kill him when he's just there? Like, you know, it's like, fuck you, Makani, boom. You know, but I got killed like 8 times by Makani.
Can we get, what's Makani doing? Impression of Matthew McConaughey and playing the scene?
Yeah, I'll talk to him. I mean, I got he's part of my 25 in my phone.
Ross McCrant, you can do a perfect Matthew McConaughey impression.
Who?
Ross McCrant from The Walking Dead.
Oh, really?
Yeah, maybe we can. Just
no,
maybe.
No, I'm not.
We're about to go to the airport and we can shoot.
Just kill him. Just kill him.
No.
All right, then. Thank you very much,
guys. Thank you for being here.
Bye.